My name is Sabika, and Sabika Abbas, because there are two Sabikas in the program. Before coming to IHS, I did my master's in modern Indian history and postgraduate specialization in conflict transformation and peace building. And I was primarily working around gender sensitization and issues around it, and also running this initiative called Sar-e-rahguzar, Poetry in the Streets. I heard it because I heard about it from a friend whose friend was an ex-fellow. Another ex-fellow was in my friend list, and they had uploaded an advertisement about the fellowship. So that's how I came to know about it. Actually, the background that I came from, although at the surface level it might seem that it is very, very different, but there were two reasons why this fellowship really attracted me. One was the initiative that I had started. It was Sar-e-rahguzar, which was actually trying to understand the subjectivity of urban experience and trying to subvert urban spaces, primarily the streets, the metros, because in this initiative I was doing performative poetry on every space that the urban provides and trying to subvert it, and also how the urban has a subjective experience. And secondly, when I was doing conflict studies, I actually realized this, studied about this new concept of conflict transformation, and that is also somehow related to this entire aspect. The third reason, the most important, was that I was done with the academia. I was part of a lot of student politics while in college, and I was really done with the laziness of the academia of sorts, in the sense that how it is not connected to the praxis and how it is not there out in the open and working on ground. So I did not want to indulge into the long conversations and debates which really end in the classroom itself and do not go on the ground. So that is why I found this fellowship to be very interesting, because it has that rigor of academia, but along with that, it also makes us aware of the practical interventions that we need to know and be a part of. So personally, I mean, which might not be the case with a lot of people, personally, I felt the person in me, the things that I wanted to do, would have rotted if I would have gone for just the academic part of it. It has been really amazing. I had come with a particular perspective, those lens that you put in your head and then you see everything through that lens. And the beginning itself was such that I started questioning that lens. You completely think that no, your brain has to adjust more lens into your head. So I started seeing things through new perspectives, and not just being tolerant of other perspectives, not just being multidisciplined, that there are so many people, there's an architect who thinks like this, there's an environmentalist who thinks like this, so I should be tolerant of their views. No, not just tolerant, but be accepting of what they are saying, and also trying to learn a lot. I mean, I learned a lot from in the way that how to see new things, how to see things in a novel way, and also that there's something far beyond my own discipline, and the rigor of groundwork is something that I've really, really learned. And I've learned that exactly what I wanted to, that the theory that is does not stand on its own in the real world. Like, for example, the project that I'm doing right now, I could have designed something which is theoretically very perfect, but when I apply it on ground, it is not going to work. So to understand the realities is something that I have really treasured over the past 7 months. So one thing is that I've realized that it is, I actually thought that it is very ideal to have diverse spaces of conversation and to get as many voices as possible to the table of discussion and discourse. But after seeing at least the batch of the fellows that we had with us, I realized that it is not impossible to create diversity, and it is not impossible to... So I would want to, although this was always there in my head, but to see it work out is something that I would take away to the possibility of it, the hope and the possibility of something like this to transform on ground is something that I would want to take away. Second that I would take away is how to work, how to practice, basically. Whether it is a practica or a project or the field work that we did or our exposure trips, I brought us one thing that how, what are the best practices when it comes to being someone, I don't like using the word professional, but for someone who indulges in a particular occupation or in a particular form of expression. So how does the practicality of it, move? And also the third thing is the people around us. How to actually not think that you will do everything. How to actually understand that the group that you work in actually has so many skills and you can levy advantage of all of those skills to create an output. I, coming from a social sciences background, the kind of discussions that you have, social sciences, at least in India, are trained in a particular way that you automatically assume yourself to be very, we know a little, we can, faff a little on or about all disciplines and talk about all disciplines. One thing that I learned about being interdisciplinary here was how to move concepts and methods when it comes to being interdisciplinary rather than being multidisciplinary. It's not about two people, X and Y coming together and making a product or coming up with an output which has elements of both. But it's actually two people coming together, working on something, and when they move out, they are different in their own selves in the methods that they use for that inquiry or for understanding concepts. So I think I am taking different ways of expression from here. Like, I never thought that I could doodle, but I started doodling. I never thought I could make models of things which are haptic. I think I've started doing that. So I never thought I'd be working on GIS. Well, that. So a lot of these interdisciplinary skills that my discipline generally did not teach us, I'm actually taking those. That it's not about how much knowledge you already have. It is primarily about how you are ready to open your mind up and engage, because it's more about that. Because in this day and age, a lot of knowledge is very easily available, although you would also learn that a lot is not available, but a lot of it is easily available, and that knowledge you can get somehow through hard work, through reading, through studying, etc. But one thing that you really, really need to be ready for is to engage with that knowledge, because that knowledge in its own self is never going to survive. So you really have to engage. And if you really get through and through this program, there are two things that you have to pay attention to. One is what kind of project that you choose, and you have to be very, very careful with that, because a lot of times you might end up choosing things that might seem difficult or might not be something that you would want to do. So be very careful on the projects that you choose, and the internships, the places that you plan to work at, the two things that you have to be very careful about. And the third is to get as much as you can, not just from the faculty that is teaching you, but from the people around you, because that's where you're going to get the most of the engagement part. Use the library to the fullest, please. The library is amazing, and you should use the library to the fullest. From first day itself, start issuing books and reading them or sitting there and reading them. So please use the library to the fullest. I think relevance is very subjective, and I don't think the entire course, but parts of that course were really relevant for me. And everything else that I got was added information and added skill, but some parts of the course were really, really relevant for me. For example, the word skill lab, it was very relevant for me. I am someone who writes on and off, and to be confident with my writing, to understand that, oh, I'm not that bad, I've gotten good reviews and things like that. So it was very important for me. So everyone has different spaces of relevance, and trust me, anyone who's applying for this course, by the time you enter, by the time 1 month has passed, you will realize what is relevant for your own self, and you'll make decisions accordingly. The structure overall is fine, but there, I really liked the rigorous setting up of base for the first few weeks and then going on into electives. I personally thought that this long break in January and some point in December, which is primarily for project work, was too much, in the sense that the break was so much that I really in the middle got bored and stopped doing my project work as well, because there was no push to work. So I thought that break was a little extended. So if it is moved in a way that the break is not that long, or when we have options of not coming to IHS because there is no teaching happening, I don't know how this would be managed, but there are those days when we don't feel like working. I am working on something very interesting. It started with something else. I was working on urban education and I wanted to build an alternative school. But while studying and while understanding alternative education and the ideas of outcome and output, etc., that this fellowship is going to teach you, I realized that anything that is one, it is going to create its own island. So I realized that I want to create a structure where I can create a skeleton of gender-sensitive pedagogy for primary and secondary school teachers in urban spaces to assist them in making classrooms more inclusive. So that's the project that I'm working on, and I am making a very interactive module on training teachers about very difficult ideas like gender identity, sexuality, sexual orientation, also devising ways on how to get into these spaces without being questioned a lot, because there's sex education, there's puberty education and body image and things like that. So how to make those conversations easy and interactive and educators more accepting to the pedagogy. My internship is in a place which is actually working with the teaching professionals and trying to work on the pedagogy and school structures and administration. So now my project is quite similar to my internship. So it is really helpful and would help me in the longer run when I'm actually planning to start my own thing around gender-sensitive pedagogy. It was fun. People here are lovely. It took me some time to grapple with, because I'm coming from a space where the hierarchy of academia really works, where you say sir and madam to people. So just that change made it easier for us. The faculty, the people over here are more accessible, fun to talk to. You learn a lot from every corner. Not that you are sitting in front of me, but after that photography skill class, I've actually started paying a lot of attention to how I click pictures. They're no longer blurry. And I think that there are a lot of things that I just gathered by talking to people around, and very encouraging. Like, the people are very encouraging. So instead of telling you what direction you should think in, they actually push you to choose your own direction, which is very, very nice. So life at IHS was fun, filled with beanbags and coffees, and staying up at late at night, being fed by the faculty, and going out for mentor lunch. It was amazing.